Should just go. PSA Nationals 20th anniversary. Glad to be here.
It's the 20th anniversary.
It's the 20th anniversary.
20th. 2-0, I guess. Not 2-2. 2-0.
It's the 20th anniversary!
PSA 20th anniversary?
It's the 20th PSA anniversary! I'm so pumped!
It's not just about Nationals for me, it's just not about PSA, it's deeper than that.
Mike has been so honorable to be stepping out on the field, one for the 20th anniversary, and then two with the list of decoys that we have out there.
Dude, I'm just gonna send it. You just ask me whatever. Like, I've been around the sport for a long time and I've had some ups and downs in my life, and I've always found this sport, you know, and the sport's always been there for me. So, dude, I get a little emotional about it. I'm sorry, but like this is a big year for me, you know, like, so I'm just really stoked to be here, and it's the 20th anniversary, and it's like, that's where I started, was Tar Heel. You know, I went there when I was 18 and got to work with Jerry and Sean and Ben and Jeff Riccio, all those old time, you know, Janet was the one that called me and was like, hey, you want to be an intern? I was like, yeah. And I was on crutches, dude. Like, and she asked me to come to be an intern. I was like, yeah. I didn't tell them about my knee though.
It's like a very bittersweet thing, because like, it's always been something that I've wanted to do. And I've seen so many people reach that pinnacle in our sport. And it's always been kind of a tougher thing coming from an international region to, of course, put myself on the map, but then also hang in there with all these guys who are just at the top of the game. So like, to me, it is literally the most important thing on my mind right now.
Honestly, I'm speechless. This year is such a big year, being the 20th anniversary of PSA Nationals. So the fact that I get asked to do this year, and it's such a big year for me because I get to share the field with so many of my mentors that kind of helped me to get to this. So I'm just absolutely speechless to be able to be here this year.
I would go into the training room, and Jeff had ISIS, you know, this was 10 years ago, and he'd be like, let's go practice level one courage test. I'm like, yeah, let's go, you know? So like, being able to have him as a mentor and learn from his dog, you know, and then train with him and do trials with him, and then Sean, you know, Siggins, he comes along, and this huge man who is like, brings all this presence, and he's always, him and Jerry have always had my back. They're like, you're a girl, yeah, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not about that. It's about being good and be able to hang with these guys and show up. You know, we're all running at the same dogs. This isn't a division here. It's not women and men, and you fight with women. You know what I'm saying? Like boxing or MMA or whatever. Like, so if you can show up and do these things, like, that's what matters.
Coming from an area where back in the early 2000s, we were looking up to all these decoys who were doing this crazy sport down here that nobody had ever heard of. It's something that I can't even talk about, to be on the same field with them, sharing the same job as them, and being held as an equal. It's just something that I can't even explain.
So I've had many mentors throughout the years. I'm fortunate this year to be able to share the field with many of those mentors, including Sean Siggins, Jeff Riccio, Sean Edwards, and even Adriana Ray. All of them have helped me throughout the years, both at trials and off the trial field. So it's an honor to be able to share the field with them this year.
It's a tough question. There's like, as a decoy, there's always people who play a small influential role in your career and in your growth, whether it's, you know, one single thing in the sport or it's a multitude of things. But I would have to say, out of all of my people who helped influence get where I've got today, I'd say Jeff Riccio. You know, he is the guy who pushed me to become a trial decoy. Before him even mentioning it, I never had any intentions to do so. So yeah, I would definitely have to say Jeff.
One of my biggest memories is being selected in 2019 to be a national select decoy. That was the first year I got selected to be national, so that was a huge honor for me. And to be able to do it two times is absolutely amazing. So
I think maybe my first, and this may be silly, But my first two-man attack, because I thought it was hilarious that it's a two-man attack, and I was like, oh, I'm out here doing the two-man attack with some guy, and I'm like a chick, right? Like, but, like, I love the two-man attack. Coming back is a big one. Like, I've had injuries, right? So, like, I've had multiple knee injuries. I've had multiple things happen in my life that have pulled me away a little bit. And being able to come back and continue to grow and continue to get better and be persistent and have the, you know, it's been a personal challenge for me, you know what I mean, to have some things happen and then come back, and here I am, like, at Nationals. I get that question often, and, you know, it does. It's a big deal, and I don't want to downplay that, because sometimes I'm really bad about downplaying that I am a female, and I'm out there, you know, doing these trials and doing regional events and now being here at Nationals. I don't want to downplay it, but again, it's like, it's fluid for me. It's like, if you can come out here, like, I'm not a big person, you know, but if you can come out here, bring energy, because Pat asked me this question earlier of, like, you know, what sets you from, like, a, you know, size-wise from Siggins to being a smaller person, I said, it's the energy you bring. It's the speed, right? And it's the technique, right? Because I can't muscle dogs like you can. I can't muscle dogs like Siggins can. Being female, like, yeah, there's I won't downplay that, but there's also small guys out there that are in the sport as well. And it's like, if I can come out here and have good technique and show up and show, I get so many women that message me, dude, and they're like, I look up to you so much. Like, I cannot believe that you are going to Nationals. And, like, that is super awesome, right? Because if I can do it, you can do it with the work. You know what I mean?
PSA decoying has evolved quite a bit over the past 20 years in a couple ways. One, in training. Training has stepped up in so many different ways. People are doing a lot more, putting a lot more thought into their training. Into the decoying. Even training of the dogs have stepped up in astronomical ways, so the decoying has as well. As far as a trial decoying, if you go back and look at the beginning of it, we were kind of walking almost like robots. We weren't even running at the dogs as fast as we used or as we do now. I want to say it was probably a little bit slower, and just like anything else in life, people, everyone's always like wanting to like one up and then step up higher and higher. So if you look at an old school courage test, it's kind of like, hey, hey, and their arm is like, is actually like this. And now it's running at the dog like so.
Well, I think it's a lot like dog training. It just gets better and better. We have some fast young decoys now that just watch us old guys do stuff and do it better. So I think it's decoys just gotten better, just like dog training. It just evolves.
I mean, so much. It's gotten a lot more organized. Decoys are way better shaped than they used to be. Coming up with very creative scenarios. They're bringing a lot more pressure than ever, I think, and just really the whole understanding of the sport and the way we train for it has evolved, and the decoys have come along with that pretty good, I think.
Yes, the dogs have evolved a lot in the most recent years, so we have to keep up with them, and the new techniques that are coming out are making stronger dogs, so we either have to get hurt or evolve.
So having the emeritus prefix to me just means I'm really old and have been here a long time. But it is an honor to be with the sport that long, and, you know, being with it since the beginning is it means a lot to me. A lot of memories over the years.
First off, it means I was born before 1980. I guess we get the OG symbol on that with that there. But in all seriousness, I think it's just you've put your time in. You've kind of earned some respect, and you've helped PSA grow somehow in the 20 years.
Everything. It's like breaking your body for as long as I have doing this, you know, to be able to reach that level. And, you know, like, I need surgery next week, right? So I'm going to be down for potentially 6 months. And it's just really cool to know that I can just walk away, rehab, and then just come back. And they'll let me, you know what I mean? It means everything to me, just to be out here for all these years and doing this. It's
I'm just happy to be on the list and still able to do it for this long. Realistically, I feel like it's a privilege to be up there. To be on the list at all is a privilege, as far as I'm concerned, but to be up there and been doing this for so long, it's kind of an honor.
PSA is getting so big, it's going worldwide. I think it's inevitable that we're gonna start having a Nationals you know, maybe not next year, maybe not the year after, but I would guess within the next 5 years, we're going to have a Nationals outside the U.S., which would be amazing. Hopefully with, you know, hopefully another breakout of COVID or the next big virus doesn't happen and stop that, but I honestly think probably within the next 5 years, I could see us going, being in another country. It's just obviously costs of taking dogs to other countries, you know, kind of hampers that a little bit, but I could see it happening for sure.
Ash and I did it in Canada, and we just figured we could get it there, and as long as we could get the fire burning, it would just catch on and keep going. And we did it in Canada, and I knew if someone would take the responsibility in other areas, it would just keep growing and growing. So yeah, absolutely. It's a great sport, and I knew it was going to take off.
I knew it when I first saw what Jerry was doing with the sport. I saw basically the potential that it could have, because it was just from one year to the next, it evolved tremendously and just kept evolving. And two, I just had a really good feeling when I saw it, and you saw all the other dog sports, and you saw, I'm not saying they're lacking anything, but for me personally, this is something that my personality was drawing me towards, with the you know, the precision that has to be in the obedience and the basically evolution of each dog, and makes you want to train a little bit harder. And then seeing one dog and thinking you kind of have an idea of what you're doing, and then seeing somebody else's philosophy and training and understanding, hey, I got to do something totally different to keep up with what's going on.
Nope. And it's crazy. And I've gotten the opportunity to travel all over Ireland, India. You know, I did the first trial in Canada. I've had some really, really cool experiences and opportunities because of this sport, and I'm extremely grateful for that. But I never thought it would get as big as it is. And now it's crazy. It's on like almost every continent, or every continent now at this point, I think, or close to it. Now I'm just like chasing goals of like, I want to try to decoy on every one of them. You know what I mean? Get brought out for that sort of stuff. But yeah, I never thought I'd see it get to this point ever.
So many years of memories. It's hard to pick a exact moment that was my favorite moment decoying, but one very memorable moment for me is catching Ricardo and not falling. So Ricardo, anybody that's ever worked him, he's a huge dog. He broke Sean Siggins' ribs. He's damaged a lot of handlers and decoys. Several have gone to the hospital. So being able to work him while I was at Tar Heel was great. And then actually my first decoy certification, I had to do a courage test with Ricardo, and I actually caught him, stood up, and was able to drive him. That was an accomplishment in itself, and unfortunately the video of that got lost.
Oh man.
Yeah, I have a ton of good memories, but I think the best memories is being on the field with the other decoys. It's just a brotherhood, backing each other up. It's just yeah, it's just a great feeling. It chokes me up a little bit.
Actually, when I think back, every memory of every dog that I've caught has a certain special place with me. So there's not one particular one. There's too many.
My first Nationals, for sure. It was a big deal. 2011. I did 6 years in a row. And 2011 was the first one. I got my first brand new suit. And I got to go out there and show off a little bit. And I was obviously younger and in better shape. So it meant a lot to me. Some people I look up to were showing their dogs and trusted me out there. And it was just an amazing opportunity I'll never forget.
Was it?
In Maryland.
Maryland?
Yeah, it was in Maryland. Yeah, the grass was about this tall. It was awesome.
For the jungle trial?
Yeah.
Most recent memorable experience is being in the back of the van with Siggins at Nationals, and me just beating the snot out of dogs with a bucket. Like, the dog goes in and bites Siggins, and then I just like calmly walk around and like kind of calmly dump water on the dog while he's biting Siggins, and just start freaking going ape on the dog. Like, that was such a cool experience. Not only because I got to beat the snot out of a dog in the back of a U-Haul, but the fact that I got to do that with Sean, who, like, Sean's known me for 10 years. Like, he certified me almost 10 years ago up in Maryland at the decoy camp, you know? So, like, he certified me, and then, like, I get to work a national event and do that with him. And not only that, but we also spend a lot of time together working at Tar Heel, you know? And I used to watch Sean, and I was like, dude, like, this guy, like... If your dog can bite Sean and, you know, stay biting Sean,
I would say it's a pretty solid dog. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I used to watch him catch and, like, drive. And, like, I've never seen a guy hit a dog with a stick like Sean Siggins can hit a dog with a stick. You know what I mean? So, like, that was pretty cool to be able to do that with him.
I think I'm a different name each time.
Each time, something different.
On my, sorry, I keep looking, I'll start over. I keep looking at you.
PSA 20th anniversary, 20th anniversary. PSA 20th anniversary. I'm sure that was horrible. I tried my best though.
Yeah, yeah. 15 years.
Yeah.
15
like
years.
A kid when
yeah.
He started.
Yeah, so. I was.
Anyway, your actual front of the camera, which is not shocking to me.
You nose here, Matt, did you?
No.
I'm getting better.
Sean said he's doing an interview. Everyone just gets quiet when the camera comes out.
Especially cops.
Oh, God.
100% cops showed up.
You know, we're going to have to edit so much. We're going to put the little smiley face emoji every time you do that. I love how Sean loves the camera. It makes my job so much easier.
I do not. I am not photogenic.